Hey, what's up mga kanaps? Na-miss nyo ba ako on screen? Sana. Anyway. Meron na akong nabasa dito sa Quora Digest. So, yun. Pinag-usapan nila kung nagsisinungin din nga ba yung Vietnam about its COVID statistic. Kasi di ba maganda yung record nila. Kaya siguro pinag-iisipan ng kung ano-ano. Usually naman daw, Amerika daw yung hindi naniniwala sa kanila. So let's hear from Andrew Dang, who live in Ho Chi Minh City. Is Vietnam lying about its COVID statistic? Vietnam is lying about its COVID statistic? How do you know? Currently, Vietnam have obtained more than 90 days without COVID infection. Within the community, with zero death, according to the Ministry of Health, over the past 24 hours, Vietnam has only 16 remaining COVID cases, in which all 16 patients are currently on medical treatment. It was on July 21, I think, wala nang COVID case sa Vietnam. Tama ba? But anyway, so my reply from, but yung reply is July 19, updated in July 21, tapos yung reply July 19, Tra Minh Ngoc, frankly speaking, who cares if the outsiders believe it or not? Na nireply ni Andrew Dang, yes, and basically we don't care if they believe or not. Because the numbers indicators of the economic growth are showing the truth that Vietnam is lying about its COVID statistic or not. Then Stephen also replied July 22, I would say a lot of the outsiders, again, sabi ni Stephen Hauser, I would say a lot of the outsiders not believing are American outsiders. And American of the fraction, the coronavirus, should appreciate the greatness of the US by giving us the lowest numbers. Most Europeans probably know, at least in the meanwhile, that your country, from your name I assume, you are Vietnamese, did a great job in this crisis. Now, with the reply of David Francisco, how the hell did people? Then Philip J. Hoffman replied with August 7, agree, Vietnamese not stupid, this is all a scam, COVID-19, biggest transfer of wealth ever in history. In this case, censoring the media served Vietnam well because the media could not destroy small business owners like it did in the rest of the world. I live in Cambodia, there are no deaths here either. And to use the phrase pandemic is nothing but scare tactics because each year we have a new influenza virus that is also pandemic. Total deaths from COVID-19 are close to the same number of deaths from the annual influenza virus. Sick world we live in, the virus is the media and the powers that control them. Robert Cook reply, wishing one of your loved ones. Then Deb Penn, why did you delete my comment? The fact that you don't care about the lie makes you believe you're safe. I thought this group is all about being objective. If you live long enough in the West and watch long enough their mainstream media and you compare the information like I do, you understand that they aren't kind to any Asian countries or Middle East. Snowden, heard about them? Heard about him? If you don't do anything about smearing and lies, the lies will take care of you. A lie repeated 1,000 will become a truth when enough people believe it. The idea on Vietnam lying about the number of COVID-19, if linger long enough, it will speak shit. BN tourism industry will eat big sheep if enough average idiots in the West starting to believe it. No one will come anymore because Big Boss West has decided that Bin is lying about the number. Mark my words, are you surprised to know that there's some idiots out there believe the earth is flat? They even have an association. Idiocy has no limit. Politics all about manipulating the average idiot majority. Comment as deleted. Nag-reply sa Flat Earth Conspiracy. The Flat Earth Conspiracy has been around for decades, but still not many in proportion to the total population. Believe it. It's not like everyone is an idiot. There are idiots thinking that Vietnam is lying and that can't be helped. But that doesn't really matter much in either short or long term. I suspect it was deleted because it sounds highly biased and uneducated, and such is not all a good representation of Vietnamese people, who tend to be courteous and polite, as you can see from other responses. Okay. Jim Catro replied July 28. No, I do not think Vietnam is lying about the coronavirus. I think they did an excellent job in containing it, evidence being the shutdown borders very quickly. Vietnam has no reason to lie about this. Don't get them confused with Chinese government. Vietnam has a very progressive, very intelligent leadership in its government. Love Vietnam, my home away from home. James Chem replied, excellent job in controlling the pandemic. I've seen on social media about the remarkable works that Vietnam did, putting human lives above profits and nonsensical individual freedom in the context of COVID, especially at the onset of the pandemic when the public pressure and uncertainty were highest. The excellent handling also showcased Vietnam's ability to mobilize and the resolve of their people to sacrifice personal gain for the greater good. It gives a glimpse of what Vietnam could potentially achieve in the future. Should she continue in the right trajectory? Some countries chose to prioritize profits and individual freedom over human lives to pander to voters, while others, such as Vietnam, China, and East Asia as a whole, choose to place human lives above all. Ultimately, it is each to its own. My hope is that those nations who succeed in managing the pandemic can convert the once-in-a-century crisis into an opportunity to economically bounce back stronger and perhaps leapfrog others in the post-COVID world. Keep up the great work and continue to stay vigilant. Good luck. Ito, magandang reply. It's not just human lives that Vietnam, from An Lam, July 23, but the best way for the economy too. Vietnam only locked down for 3 weeks due to the fast and decisive response, like other countries which has months of lockdowns. Actually, this was not even a total lockdown, since you could still get takeaways and travel outside. Businesses and domestic travel have recovered, and the economy was much less disrupted than had Vietnam followed what other countries did. Even with the treatment, Vietnam's first patient was an older man from Wuhan who had cancer, and he was treated. Madami palang hindi naniniwala sa nangyayaring pandemic. Pero simple. If maniniwala lang siguro sila kung sila mismo yung nagka-COVID. Saka, kita naman sa mga ospital, wala na mga pesto. Dito sa Pilipinas, puno na doon yung mga ospital. And I don't wanna get closed door. But I can see naman, may mga tent sa labas. So, ibig sabihin, hindi na talaga nakapasok sa loob. So, COVID, yung COVID, totoo. Saka, may ilang taon na rin akong kilalang namatay sa COVID. Pero, syempre, may data props. Ano tayo, privacy. So, hindi natin i-ano. And then, si ex-mayor Alfredo Lim sa COVID din namatay. As was reported na rin sa media. Sa may dati ding senator way back ago, na matanda na kasi, sa COVID din siya namatay. Diba? So, bakit? Why don't you believe it? Eh, madami naman na nababalita sa social media na namatay, mga doktor, ganun. But, bakit hindi kayo maniwala? Mag-stay at home na kayo. Maniwala kayo. Tatagal to. Hanggat pasaway tayo. Yun lang. So, please like, share, and subscribe, mga kanats. Thank you. Bye-bye.